In today's Teams tutorial, I'll cover essential tips for teachers. Now, some of these tips will help you keep your students engaged, and some will help you get organized. I'm Leila from Excel Plus, and I teach an Excel course at a university. Last year, we switched to Teams. I also use Teams to teach non-university courses. Now, if you're brand new to Teams, make sure you watch this tutorial first, which introduces you to the whole Teams environment. Once you're ready, let's start with my tips. Tip number one, launch polls from a meeting. If you'd like to add polls to your meeting, go to your calendar, go to the meeting you want to add the poll to, and click on the plus sign. Then add the app Forms to your meeting. It's going to ask you for permissions, just click on Add, and now you can create a poll before or during your meeting. Let's save this. To see how it looks, let's create a new poll. Let's add a question, add in our options, and then decide on some important factors that affect our poll. Do we want to share the results automatically after voting so everyone can see the results? Or do we want to keep these anonymous so only we can see the results? If you don't want co-authors for your poll, remove this and then save your poll. Notice only I can see this poll while it's in draft mode. The moment I launch the poll, others can see it as well. Now you can create multiple polls, launch some of these before the meeting and some during the meeting. In this case, I want to launch this during the meeting. But one thing to mention though, is that others can close your poll or delete your poll if they have presenter rights. So if you don't want your students to mess with this, make sure in the details of your meeting, in the meeting options right here, that you have the right people selected here who can present. If only you should be responsible for polls, switch this to only me and save these options. Now let's go and take a look at how this looks during a meeting. I'm going to go ahead and join this meeting. I can see that Kim is already here and I have the polls option. Now from Kim's view, she can't see any polls yet. Only I can see these. So now I want to get the meeting started to see who has experience with Power BI. I'm going to launch this. Now what happens is all the participants are going to get a pop-up on their screen and they get to submit their results. Let's submit a response and click on submit. Because the results aren't anonymous, everyone gets to see the results. Tip number two. Use Together mode. If you have five or more students, you can use Together mode to bring them in the same scene. Here I'm in the standard gallery view. Let's go to More options and select Together mode. This is going to seat each of you in a separate chair. You can change the scene here. Let's go with this dark chair version and click on Apply. So as you can see, we have students of all ages. Let's go and see what other scenes we have. Just go to Change Scene. Now the numbers on top are the numbers of the persons that can be shown in each scene. I'm going to go with this Minecraft one, click on Apply, and now we're in this more fun setting. Together mode is great to bring the people in the same scene and also make more people visible on the screen. Disable chat during a meeting. If you find that your students are completely distracted by the chat and they're not paying attention to what you're saying because they're having their own fun in the chat, you can disable it during your meeting. Just go to More options and select Meeting options. On the bottom, you have Allow meeting chat. You can switch this to disabled. Now let's just pause there. I want to show you something. Notice we also have an option called In meeting. This enables the chat only during the meeting, so chat will be closed once the meeting is over. Now check this out, the moment I press save, they're going to stop having fun because chat is going to be closed and they have to pay attention to what I'm saying. We can see here chat has been closed. Now you can go back and turn it on anytime you want. Tip number four, annotate your screen with ZoomIt. ZoomIt is a free app that helps you annotate your screen as you're presenting. It also helps you easily zoom in and zoom out. To download it, just Google or Bing it. You're going to see a link to the docs.microsoft website. Just click on it. It's going to take you to the download page. Here, you just have to download it and then run it. And then ZoomIt will be available in your tray. You activate it with hotkeys. So if I scroll down here, you're going to see a list of shortcuts that you can use as you're presenting. Now, you are probably going to pick a few that you're going to stick to, and they're pretty easy to remember. So I've already downloaded it. I'm just going to jump into a meeting and show you how you can use these in action. Okay, so here I'm in a meeting and I want to share my screen. Let's share a desktop. And let's say I want to cover the aggregate function with my students. To zoom in, I'm going to use Control 1. To bring attention to a specific part of this formula, I can use Control, select the left mouse key, and draw a rectangle. To draw an arrow, use Control Shift. Now you can change the thickness of these and the color of your annotations by holding down Control and scrolling. You make your ink either thinner or thicker. If you'd like to change the color, you can use the shortcut key B to switch to blue, G to switch to green, and so on. Now, all of these shortcuts are listed on the page that I showed you before. To get rid of all your annotations and reset the zoom, just press Escape. If you'd like to use the annotations without zooming in, you can use Control 2 to activate the ink, and then use the other shortcuts to annotate your screen. Press Escape to leave the annotation mode. Tip number 5, use two devices. Using another device is a great way to check student experience. It's also great if you're sharing your desktop and you want to keep your eye on chat. The way you can do this is to first log in from the device you'll be using to present, just so you get everything set up for the meeting. So in this case, I've started the meeting from my PC and I'm going to share my screen. Let's share desktop. Then I'm going to join the meeting from another device. So if you have a second laptop or tablet available, log into Teams with the same username and then join the meeting again. So in this case, the meeting I'm joining is a channel meeting, but this works for any meeting. Just make sure you deactivate your audio and camera on the second device and then join. You can then bring up the chat and keep your eye on screen resolution, zoom level, and student experience. Tip number 6, download the attendance list. As long as the meeting is active, you can download the list of participants. Now, while you're in the meeting, go to Show Participants. Under More Actions, you can download the attendance list. This downloads an Excel file. Let's go ahead and open it to see how it looks. You get the full name of the person, the action, so whether they joined or left, and the timestamp for that action. Tip number 7, use the whiteboard. When you're in a meeting, you can share the whiteboard with students to allow them to participate more in the meeting. To share the whiteboard, go to Share Options and select Microsoft Whiteboard. Now, the first time you open this in the meeting, you can decide if only you can edit or if you want to collaborate with the students on the whiteboard. We're going to go ahead and collaborate. This way, each student can go and add their input onto the whiteboard. They can add notes here, adjust size, move these around, change the color, and so on. If at any point in time you want to turn off the ability for them to be able to edit the whiteboard, go to Settings here and turn off the option that other participants can edit. This way, only you are in control of the whiteboard. And you can add some information for them and leave this on the screen so that everyone can see. Tip number 8, check your assignment options. Let's add a new assignment to this team here. So I'm going to go to Team, to the General channel, and in the tabs here, select Assignments. Currently, there aren't any assignments here, so let's quickly create one. We can choose to create a quiz or an assignment or use an existing one. I'm going to go ahead and create a new assignment. Give your assignment a title. Add in any instructions you want. You can also upload additional resources. Put in how many points you want this to have. I'm going to go with 20. This is the class it's assigned to. It's currently assigned to all students. But here's an important option that's quite hidden. It says here, don't assign to students added to this class in the future. You can change this. So in case a student enters the class later on, after the assignment has been created, they will get notified that there is an assignment for them to do. So I'm going to select Assign to All Students, add it to this class in the future, and click on Done. Next, you can define the due date and the time due. And here you even have more options. Because if I go ahead and click on Assign here, it's going to create the assignment right away. Now I can save this in my drafts and assign it later, but I can also schedule this. So let's go to Edit and schedule the assignment to go live at some point in the future. Place a check mark here and then select your post date. So let's make this assignment go live on Friday. And for post time, let's go with 4 p.m. Due date is Sunday, midnight. That's great. You also get to decide whether you want to close this off so that late turn-ins aren't allowed. If you check this box, they can't turn it in. If you leave it unchecked, they can turn it in after the due date. Once you've adjusted these, click on Done. Now, in addition to this, you also can decide where to post the notification about this assignment. Default is general, but you can edit that. Because this assignment is about Power BI, I'm going to post it to the Power BI channel and click on Done and then schedule this. Tip number 9. Update assignment settings. Once you have an assignment set up, you can adjust the default for future assignments. Go to More Options here and select Assignment Settings. So you can change the default due date for all your future assignments. I'm going to change this to 6 p.m. If you want new students to receive assignments that you created before they joined the class, switch this to Yes. You get to also change the default channel that you put notifications in about assignments right here. Now remember, you can control these individually from each assignment, but this allows you to set some defaults so you don't have to change these settings all the time. Enable Turn-in Celebrations is on in this team. This is what they see when they turn in an assignment. If you don't want them to get the celebration, you can turn this off. And finally, tip number 10, make student names anonymous when you're grading. So let's say I'm ready to grade some assignments. I'm going to jump to the assignment tab and let's go to the Power BI dashboard. Now in this case, only two people have turned in the assignment, but let's assume that everyone has turned it in and I'm ready to grade these. To make sure I'm not biased towards anyone, I can hide the names. So go to Options here and hide the student names. This is going to shuffle and hide the names. This way you can review the assignment, give your feedback, put in your grades, and once you're done, you can show the student names. I hope you found some new tips here that you can apply to your future classes. If you have tips of your own, please share these in the comments. I'd love to know, and I'm sure other teachers will benefit as well. Now, before you leave, if you're new to this channel, welcome, and make sure you subscribe if you want to improve your skills and stay up to date. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.